I'm super excited about today's episode because we have Kiernan Shipka.
Hello.
Star of Sabrina, dog lover, sweetest girl on the planet, fashionista extraordinaire. Let's give her a call. I'm Antoni, and this is Show Me What You're Working With, where you show me what you have in your kitchen, and I make a meal for you. Hey.
Hello.
Oh, you're so chic. How are you so chic in...
How are you so chic? I don't know. I'm just living my life.
I'm such a slob. I did take a shower today, but I'm just wearing like a crummy t-shirt and gym shorts.
I didn't take a shower today, so you have that on me. So there we go.
So who are you quarantining with? Like, what's your situation been like?
Yes. So I am with my family and a good friend and my dog. I can't forget about my German Shepherd.
She's so adorable.
I never realized how much I loved actually going to restaurants, like meeting friends, family style meals, late night ice cream runs, all of it I am yearning for.
I want to know kind of like what you're working with, what you got in your kitchen.
Yeah, let's go over to my fridge. I have a lot of greens in here. We got spinach. I have mint. I also have arugula.
Nice. Cheese drawer.
Cheese drawer. I have halloumi.
Love halloumi.
I have like medjool dates.
Okay, those are awesome. Nice, sweet, sticky, toffee-ish. I really respect the fact that you keep them in your fridge. Wait, what's next to the dates?
Watermelon.
What kind of grains do you have?
I have brown rice, I have quinoa, I have millet.
You know what I love about you? That you're one of those people who like, you know exactly what's in your pantry.
I know how much tahini I have left.
It's all so clear to me now. Let's do like a salad-y grain bowl situation. And obviously we have to grill halloumi.
Of course. That's one thing we know.
Yes. I'm really excited to make this for you.
Yeah, this is gonna be great.
Thank you so much, Kiernan.
Bye.
Bye. Okay, so we're gonna do a salad grain bowl with some grilled halloumi, sweet sticky dates, some fresh juicy watermelon, mint, and a creamy lemony tahini vinaigrette. Let's go. Okay, so for our green salad bowl, we have fresh watermelon, olive oil, some fresh cracked pepper, a block of halloumi that I slice, Marcona almonds with paprika, leftover grains from the week. This is some farro that I'm using, some lemons, fresh mint, medjool dates, tahini, a bit of cayenne, which is optional, but really good in this. Neon playing with her ball, good girl. And some fresh arugula. Ooh, that's a strong coffee. First things first, I want to make a nice little marinated watermelon cube situation that we're going to put into our salad. So we'll get started with that. Okay, we're barely going to use half of this. Beautiful. The first thing I'm going to do is actually cut this top off just to anchor it a little bit. And then you just cut along the edges to get rid of all the rinds. Now you're just going to cut little slices about 1 inch, flip it over and turn it around again. And then just slice down, and you have perfect, even cubes. Should we see if Neon likes watermelon?
No.
She's into it! This is gonna look a little weird, but trust me, it's gonna be amazing. You're gonna take some olive oil, and you're just gonna douse the watermelon. Watermelon is really light and filled with, well, water. So we really wanna fatten it up nicely so you have these really good, juicy bites. It gets even weirder. Again, just have a little faith. You're gonna crack a lot of pepper. And the pepper is just gonna have a nice little kick when you bite into it, and it's gonna be awesome. And this is our marinated watermelon. We're gonna let this sit on the side for a little bit while we assemble the rest. So now we're gonna make a nice little tahini vinaigrette. Tahini is awesome. It's basically sesame paste, and you can add all kinds of stuff to it for like a really nice creamy vinaigrette. We're gonna grab a little bowl, grab your tahini. This is probably like 4 tablespoons. No, it's probably more like 6. Cayenne is really awesome. If you add just a little bit, it really wakes up flavors in literally anything. So just add a tiny little touch. You won't even taste the spice in it, but it's really gonna take your tahini to the next level. And since we're making a lemon tahini, cue the lemons. Zest of a lemon, the free ingredient that already comes with a lemon when you buy it. And again, you don't wanna get the pith. You only wanna get the yellow part, because that's the part that's delicious. Now that we have the zest, we're gonna use the juice. The juice is gonna add some really nice acid, and it's gonna thin out the tahini a little, so it's gonna be easier to spread and put into our salad. So I used about half a lemon. I'll grab a little bit of salt, and then whisk it up. So it really tends to thicken, so I'm gonna add a little bit of water just to thin it out. Perfect. There you go. You basically want it to be a little thinner than like a pancake batter. Just like that. Now I want pancakes. Halloumi, the unsung cheese of the cheese world. It's from Cyprus. It's made from sheep's milk, so lactose intolerance can enjoy it. You want to cut it up into nice little quarter inch pieces, just like this. And we're just gonna kiss it on a pan to get it nice and brown and crispy. So I have a nonstick pan on medium, medium high heat. If you have a grill pan, that's really awesome as well. I'm gonna put about a tablespoon of olive oil on here. I wanna test it out. Oh yeah. When you place your piece of cheese on the pan, if it starts to sizzle, that means you're ready to go. So I'm gonna put my pieces on. Neon. Wow. Neon. You like that a lot more than the watermelon, don't you? So these aren't gonna be here for a very long time. You can even check them. See? Already brown and beautiful. Gorgeous. So these are already brown. It literally took about 45 seconds. You can turn off the heat and remove them from the pan. These are perfect, and it took less than a minute to make. Can't wait to try these. We are ready to make our salad, but before we do that, I'm gonna do two things. One, have a bite of watermelon. And two, move on to happy hour. Welcome to happy hour. You are biting today. So after meeting Kiernan's dog, Frankie, we knew we wanted to spend a little bit of extra time with our two very talented pups.
So this week we're going paw to paw with a few challenges to showcase their skills. Not that it's a competition.
But it is. Best sleeper. I think Neon would definitely lose that one because she doesn't even sleep at night.
We have a theory that she's never slept a minute in her entire life.
Yep.
I think Frankie would win in most any kind of nap and or sleeping competition. She takes her beauty rest super seriously, don't you, Frankie?
Most vocal. If it were 3 a.m., Neon would have this one in the bag.
Frankie, can you speak?
Most sophisticated palate. Neon loves a bone broth. She's had Wagyu and she's a big fan, but also she tried to eat a cigarette off the street.
Best smile. She does get this really demonic grin. You can flash back to the first episode. I think you caught a bit of that one, huh?
Frankie, can you smile for Antoni?
Yay!
Best snuggler. She's not really a snuggler.
Neon, calm.
Frankie is also an incredible snuggler.
Sit, pop, stay.
Good
wow.
Girl.
So well trained. Wow.
She says, no, I'm just gonna serve looks.
Wow, two fierce competitors.
Let us know who you think won. Was it Neon or was it Frankie? And on that note, back to the kitchen. All right, so we're ready to assemble our salad. First step, we're gonna dress our arugula. Here I have farro, which is a really nice nutty grain. You can use quinoa, barley, brown rice, and then dress it with a little bit of olive oil. Don't want any dry greens. Toss that up. We're gonna put our greens on the base. I'm gonna try to get as much height as I can here. A little bit of that farro. Our next step are cubes of watermelon. So these, I'm just gonna lay them around. I love layering a salad. It's like a story that's coming to life. That's maybe the cheesiest thing I've ever said in my life, but that's really what it feels like. Never said I was cool. Perfect. I'm gonna be using Marcona almonds, which is like the fanciest almond. You can use regular almonds. You can use pistachios, sunflower seeds, or no nuts at all if you have a nut allergy. Sweet, sticky, medjool dates. I love a date. High in protein, high in fiber. My suggestion, keep these guys in the fridge so that they're nice and firm. So if you're cutting them open, they're gonna be a lot easier to slice. And our next step, our beautiful, creamy, pancake battery, lemon tahini. Gorgeous. And then finally, fresh mint. This is what's gonna take it next level. Mint is really delicate, and if you cut it, it tends to brown on the edges. So I actually like just to rip some little pieces and just throw them in. It smells so nice. Mm. Finally, our halloumi. Just lay them on, nice and messy. Doesn't have to look perfect. And why not just a little touch of the tahini, because our halloumi deserves some as well. We are ready to taste. And by we, I mean me. So I'm gonna get the perfect little piece of halloumi. I got a date, I have some fresh mint, I have my arugula, get some farro, a little watermelon cube. It's gonna be a big bite.
That was a really big bite.
This is summer in a plate bowl. You have the sweet, juicy watermelon with that little kick of pepper. You have nice little lemony, creamy tahini. The smoky almonds, the sweet, sticky date. I just felt that like right here in my brain. Kiernan, I'm really excited for you to make this. This is so freaking good.
Hey, Antoni, that was so good. The recipe was absolutely 10 out of 10. Would recommend. In the grilled halloumi club for life. Thank you so much. Also, I'm never eating a salad without chopped dates in it again. So good.
If you're in a position to give, you can join me in supporting the Okra Project. They're a fantastic organization feeding our Black trans community.